God, yes.
You hear something?
No.
No, I heard something. Hold on.
Are you there? Bobby, please, I'm scared.
People, you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.
Well, does that mean I can stay at your place tonight, Trent?
Sure, Dwayne, why not? I'll be at your mom's anyway.
I hate small towns.
Come on, we're gonna be home tomorrow. Can you just have fun for 1 minute?
Yeah, well, if I didn't feel that there was a gigantic sign over my head saying homo, then maybe.
What more could you ask for? Rich mahogany, deep musky smells. Burly men.
Shush.
Hey, you boys, you look all pretty gussied up there. I figure you might be taking one of us home tonight.
Yeah, we could sit around and give each other fashion advice.
Yeah.
We could practice kissing.
And when I see your dad later, I'll tell him you say hi.
Now you can go and hurt my feelings.
Yeah, maybe we should escort those boys home.
Come on, you guys, get a move on.
Now you boys go straight home and leave those guys alone.
Hey, Trent, do you mind closing the bar by yourself tonight? I need to go home.
You going now?
Well, yeah, I'm exhausted. You don't have to run a gauntlet of men trying to grab your ass every night.
Yeah. Yeah, I can finish up.
Cool. I tell you what, next time you have a bunch of guys trying to grab your ass, I'll clean the bar myself.
Yeah, this place sucks. Same drunken idiots. Nothing ever changes.
Well, it ain't so bad, is it?
There are moments less horrendous than others.
Beer on the wall.
Well, hello, boys.
Whoa, don't you boys look all turny. There's some sort of fairy convention in town.
Well, George, once they saw your good jokes, how could they stay away?
Shut your hole.
Frankie, look, one wants to give you a kiss.
Hate to break it to you, but I ain't your type.
Fuck her up, baby. Oh, Jesus Christ!
Bar's closed, boys. Seriously, fuck off. Bar's closed. Okay, now you're seriously starting to piss me off.
Trent! Trent! Keep the door closed, keep it locked!
What the hell is going on?
What do you mean, what the hell is going on?
Haven't you looked outside?
Okay, why is everyone dressed up?
They're all dead! Not just dead. They're parading around out there like it's a frickin' pride parade.
Well, wait a sec, back it up. Zombies. Gay zombies? That's ridiculous.
Well, it ain't no hoedown. Men are eating men out there, then they'd be coming back to life and trying to dress like the Fruit Twins over here.
I would never wear anything like that.
I don't even wear flannel pajamas.
How did you guys get away?
We ran. They may be scary, but they're slow.
I ran into them in Georgia on the way here.
We've been running all over the place trying to find a place to hide. But they're everywhere.
I mean, it happened at my place too.
Wait. What happened?
I drove home. When I got in the house, I could hear something coming from the closet. So I picked up a hammer. But when I opened the closet door, Dad? All that hair in my lingerie.
You got lingerie?
Shut it. The town has been overrun. I came here because I knew you would be here.
Okay, you know, it's a good thought, but we can't stay here.
What? Why? There's nowhere else to go.
Because if what you're saying is true, then as soon as they realize we are here, they're gonna bust through that window.
I escaped three leather-bound loggers to get here. Dwayne and Frank are dead, man. Game over, man.
I felt like Goldilocks with all those big bears out there.
We need to get to a truck or something. We need to get out of town.
Oh, well, that's just dandy. How do you think we're gonna do that with all of them out there?
Set up a perimeter.
Let's block all the entrances and then figure out how to get out of here.
Why don't you two make yourselves useful and go play with the curtains or something?
Oh, right. I forgot just how useful playing with the curtains was.
Just do something, all right?
Trent, what is your problem?
What do you mean?
Well, it's not gonna help with you riding their asses.
It might. I'm sorry. You know what? It's a long story.
Well, get over it. We need you. I need you. Now, how many shells do you have?
Not enough.
Well, let's blast them zombie queers and get the hell out of here.
Wouldn't that be considered a hate crime?
We can't kill them. They're already dead. Besides, we don't have enough shells.
Hey, I got it. What if I do some sweet-ass spy moves and sneak out to my truck?
What?
Yeah, look, I got camo on. You guys can cover me and I'll be all stealthy and shit. They won't even see me.
That is gonna be the stupidest thing I've ever heard. Besides, I need you here, us real men. We have to stick together.
Hey, we are all in this together.
Trent, seriously, what is your deal?
I'm sorry, it's just seeing them reminds me of my brother.
Your brother is the all-star tight end on the university football team.
That's what we told everyone. 3 months after he left, we never heard from him. So I went down to check on him, you know, see if he's okay. And he wasn't even registered. So just as I was about to leave and call the cops, I saw this. His picture on a poster for a club.
Oh my God! Your brother is Will Hungus?
Bravo, sir. He's so fierce.
You know, it's not the fact that he's gay or that he's a stripper. It's that he felt he couldn't tell me.
Oh, jeez. I'm getting all misty. Why don't I go out there and tell all the flesh-eating zombies that we need a timeout because we're sharing?
Shut up, George.
We don't have enough shells to go out blasting. Besides, it'll just draw attention to ourselves.
Fine, sit here in the dark and talk about your emotions like a bunch of pansies. I'm going out to my truck, and if you're all lucky, I'll drive back here and save your dumbasses.
It's suicide, man.
Fuck this. I can see my truck out there, and I'm going for it.
Oh my God, oh my God! Oh my God! Oh my God!
couldn't come up with a better plan than this stupid scheme.
George, listen to Trent.
Fuck off. Now cover me.
Fuck me!
Oh.
Jesus. Okay, we need a distraction. We need to draw them away from us so we can somehow get to a vehicle.
Our car is parked near the motel.
Well, what do zombies want?
To eat meat?
Right, so how do we get them to not want to eat us?
I think we're forgetting these are not ordinary zombies.
What do you mean?
Maybe there's something Gaiman-like that we could use to distract them.
So if they're all gay, then I'm okay, right?
Well, there might be some lesbian zombies out there. They might just be off listening to folk music or watching Ellen.
Whatever. What do gay men want? I bet if we had enough mirrors, we could distract
dancing!
Them on
dancing!
What?
Dancing! Gay men love to dance!
Oh, God, yes! Remember what happened when George's car alarm went off?
Right.
So, how do we get them to dance and not eat us?
When gay men go dancing, they don't eat.
If that's true.
Why?
There's a million and one reasons.
All that matters is if these zombies are anything like real gay men, they will not want to eat while they're dancing.
Well, all we have is country music. Will they dance to that?
Yeah. Gay cowboys. Like that'll ever happen. I do have a CD my brother gave me that he used to strip to.
That's perfect.
Here we go! It's tricky to rock around, that's right, on time, it's tricky! It's tricky, tricky, tricky! Was kinda curly. Went to her house and bust her out. I had to leave real early.
These girls are really sleazy. All they just say is please me. Or spend some time and rock around. I said it's not that easy.
It's tricky to rock around, to rock around. That's right, on time is tricky.
Holy shit! Play the music! Play the music! They're not dancing! They're not dancing! Everybody, come on! Follow me! Follow me! Come on! God, thank God you guys are here. Sweet
oh
Jesus!
My God. Put the music on! Music, go!
There's no more room in hell. The dead will dance the earth.
I wanna take you to a gay bar.
in you. I've got something to put in you. I've got something to put in you.
No.
At the gay bar, gay bar, gay bar.
People, you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. What does-